If you want to know how I run my home lab, what devices I have, what applications I use, and how I run them, then this is the video for you. I think some of you are going to be surprised, so stay tuned. Let's switch to my article for a second. I'm not a hardware guy or a software guy, so I write my articles and make my videos in a way that even I can understand. I have been using Docker and traffic for over 6 years now. My Docker and traffic guides have been read by millions of people. In 2024, I decided to revise all of my guides. From that was born the Ultimate Docker Server series. In this series, I cover everything from preparing the operating system to having a secure authentication layer such as Authelia. To go along with this series of guides, I'm also going to be making a bunch of different videos. This video is a prequel for what is about to come. But before I do that, I wanted to show you guys how my home lab looks like. This way, you can better understand why I do certain things certain way. When it comes to home lab, my philosophy is simple. Keep it simple, keep it energy efficient. I have no intention of running a data center type rack in my home, consuming hundreds of watts of electricity. But it's just me.
Look at this electric bill!
What type of home labber are you? Let me know in the comment section, I'm curious. This is a rabbit hole and it's a complex one, but we're gonna go into this together like an army, maybe a geek army. Well, I think that's a really nice name. I'm gonna call you guys and myself Geek Army from now on. So let's keep going, Geek Army. So back on my guide here, this is the first of the series of guides on Docker server. Here I explain my environment. It's really important that you guys at least have an idea of what my environment looks like so you can better understand my guide. So basically, I have 5 Docker hosts, my home server, which is a Proxmox LXC container on my home server, or my Proxmox host, which is, if you scroll all the way down, you're going to see this. It's a very simple mini PC, but it's very powerful. Thick. Till the end, you're going to be really surprised as to how many things I run on this stuff. Okay, back up now. Again, home server is a Proxmox LXC container. Then I have a media database server that's also a Proxmox LXC container. I have a Raspberry Pi running AdGuard Home and Unbound DNS on it. At some point, I will also install WireGuard on it using Docker so I can VPN into my home. The next one here is the web server, which obviously is not hosted in my home because anything that requires a lot of reliability, I do not believe in hosting in my home environment. So this is a virtual private server, as you can see on the screen, on DigitalOcean VPS. It has 4 GB of RAM memory, 2 virtual CPUs, and 80 GB of hard drive. Now going back to my list, the last one on the list is my Synology DS918 NAS. This also runs Docker, but I use it on a need basis because I'm on a mission to cut down the electricity usage of my home lab, and having all 9 disks in my Synology NAS spinning, that's a lot of electricity. So I am trying to find ways to make my Synology NAS hibernate the disks when not in use for extended periods of time. So this has been a challenge. So if you guys have any idea, let me know in the comment section because I'm really curious to get my power consumption as low as possible. Okay, we're gonna jump in right now and I'm gonna show you my home lab. Let's go, Geek Army, my humble, simple home lab. What I have here is nothing fancy, really what most typical users would like to have in their home. So I have the UPS at the bottom and I have a Raspberry Pi inside this black case right there. As I said, my ad blocker and DNS runs on this. I have my top 10 i7-13800H mini PC. That's been very powerful, surprisingly powerful. So if you're interested in taking a look at it, go back to my guide and scroll down and you will see all the different details on how I have it here. So then I have the Synology DS918 NAS with the 4 disks. I recently added an extension bay with 5 disks, so that's 9 disks. And then I have some external hard drives on the side, which I use on need-to-know basis. This is my simple home lab, mini lab. Now, let's take a look at what this simple hardware can do, and I think you are going to be really surprised. Let's go over to my Proxmox here. So here you can see all the different hosts that I am running right now, many virtual machines and many LXC containers, so DNS. This is a secondary one compared to my Raspberry Pi I just explained. So AdGuard Home, it's nice to have some redundancy. So this is a second AdGuard Home instance. And that really helps make sure that the ad blocker is working all the time. The next one is the media and database server. The next one is the home server. Both of them are LXC containers. As you can see, they both have about 24 gigabytes of RAM and 12 CPUs. When it's normally running, I'm barely utilizing all the resources. And if I go back up and show you my node, you're going to see that the load is only about 4-5% most of the time, and I'm only using about, I don't know, 33% of the RAM. Then, okay, let's go down the list. I have Pi-hole, I have a few other testing containers, I have Home Assistant OS. We're going to talk more about this in just a little bit. Then I have a Proxmox backup server as well. I have a 4 terabyte hard drive on my Proxmox host, and Proxmox backup server backs up all of my containers and virtual machines in the SSD every day at night. So this is what I'm running on the home server. I'm barely hitting 5% of the resources. Now, if I go into the details of what I'm actually running here, I have the Portainer instance from my home server. I have the business edition, which can connect to 3 different Docker hosts for free. So you see 3 of my 5 Docker hosts here. You can see I'm running 31 containers, 20 containers, and 18 containers. So if I go into my home server instance and look at the containers, you're going to see all the typical home lab stuff that most people would be looking at. Guacamole, all the star apps or the ARR apps, Altelia, Notifier, Firefox, Dozel, bunch of different things, virtual studio code server. And in my media server, I have Plex, Jellyfin, Arisonic Advanced, Prometheus as a database, InfluxDB as a database, MariaDB as a database. At any time, if you want to know what I have running in all of these Docker hosts, you can always go back to my GitHub and check out one of these Docker compose files. For example, if I go into the media server Docker host I was just talking about, you can see that I have, let's see, right here, I have Arisonic Advanced, Jellyfin, Plex, as I was just talking about. I also have Tautuli to monitor Plex, and I have Prometheus, MariaDB, InfluxDB, and Node Exporter for monitoring the metrics of my media server. Now, on my web server, I have pretty similar stuff, but then in addition, I have Nginx Proxy Manager, PHP, MariaDB, and things like that. Okay, so this is in short what my home server and home lab can do. Now, it would be really nice to also share with you guys where I do everything. Where am I sitting and making my videos? Where am I sitting and writing my guides late into the night? So, voila. So once again, a simple, humble setup, nothing really fancy. What I would like to highlight though is that Fire tablet in the back on the wall. It's a home assistant dashboard that I built that gives me a quick overview of what's going on in my home, what's the status of the doors, what's the status of my security system. Devices are low on battery, they show up. Listen to this. If a Docker container is down, I will see that as a warning on the screen as well. So it's really cool. Okay, I'm going to switch over to another screen so you can see how it exactly looks like. This is what it is. This is what I'm seeing on my Fire tablet right there. If you have gotten this far in this video, please like, subscribe so you get notified of future videos. Because if you find this cool, then I really would like to show you guys how I did this in future, so you can also replicate what I have here. So going back to my dashboard right there, just a bunch of different things to help out my family. Is the internet working or not? With just one click, and I can turn off and turn on the ad blocker. Are there any downloads happening right now? What is the status of my security system? I mean, nothing fancy here, but the whole right side is quite empty. But If there are stuff that are happening that needs my attention, they show up on the list on the right side. Otherwise, it's going to be pretty empty. And I have like 100 different conditions here that will show me if something is going wrong. Obviously, I follow a few other things. What's the space left on my hard drive, because downloads are happening and I need to keep track of how much space I have in my hard drive so I don't crash stuff. Obviously, this is not the final location of my media. It goes to my NAS, which I sync every day at night. In the center, I also have my calendar pulled up, taxes, cleaning. I am definitely not going to do the cleaning, but let's see if I will win that battle. But the left side and the right side are the most important ones for me. For example, if I see that some of my Docker containers are down right now, I can quickly switch over to my Docker tab, and it gives me an overview of all of my Docker clothes. Isn't that cool? So once again, if you haven't subscribed, subscribe to my channel so I can show you how I did this. So this, in short, what I can do with my home lab. Once again, the idea was to give you guys a background of my home lab. This way, when you read my guides, you can better relate to it. And what I do is, from all of these five Docker hosts that are described in here, I sync all of these files using sync thing to my home server. This way I have a copy of all my important files in one location. And from here, I push all of the files to my GitHub repository, which is right here, which I think most of you might be familiar with, or if not, please check it out. There are lots of cool things in here. This is not just some example. This is the real setup that I use in my home, and really, really nice stuff in here. And if you do like it, or if you have found this useful in the past, consider hitting the star. This is just like liking a YouTube video, which, once again, if you haven't liked this video, please do give it a thumbs up and follow my channel so you get notified of all future videos. Okay, and the last point I would like to do is if you really are looking forward to automating the whole thing, you know, I have 11,000, 12,000 words of articles in there to help you set up your home lab. But if you really want to automate everything, I developed auto traffic script, which is based on all of my experiences from the last 6 to 7 years. This can automate setting up your operating system, setting up traffic, pulling the SSL certificate, setting up Authelia, installing a bunch of different apps. Everything is possible. Don't take my word for it. Check out some of the feedback that's been posted here from some of the followers on our Discord and YouTube and everything. So, and if you really want to know how the script works, there is a YouTube video playlist. Check it out. It shows all the different features. Obviously, I keep adding a lot of features, and this video here does not cover everything. So check auto traffic out if you're really interested in automating everything. It saves you a lot of time. And the last point, we really have a cool Discord server. We have over 1,000 people, lots of people helping out each other. So if you really like it, you might be able to find help in here. And if you really like what I do, at this point, I can't really monetize my YouTube content. I'm just starting out. So if you really like what you do, please consider becoming a member. There are many different levels, so nothing, no amount is small. If you do not want to become a member, you can just buy me a coffee or something, just one-time contribution. Every little bit helps out. But I have several different membership levels with different levels of benefits. So I would really appreciate if you check it out and become a member and support my work. So I really hope you guys found this video helpful. Go Geek Army.